So we will make AVS with RAID 5 audio video streaming application with RAID 5 server. So what is the need of this application? So IIT Bombay has been playing an important role to enhance the teaching skills of the faculty colleagues across the country. And for this purpose, we conduct workshops for teachers online mode. And for this purpose, we need a online teaching tool. Now we have been using AVU Classroom, which has been developed by Amrita Kollam University. So, but there is a difficulty to use this because it is working on Flash Media Streaming Server. That is a proprietary software of the Adobe. And the license cost of this software is around 1.7 lakh rupees for educational institute. So we want to shift all the front-end application and back-end application to the RAID 5 server. AVU Classroom is a audio video conferencing type tool, but it has some features to teachers. Teacher can upload the document, teacher can write on the whiteboard. So this is a similar tool of audio video conferencing tool. So streaming server, I said that AVU uses Adobe Flash streaming server. So we want to make a similar tool with same functionality in this application using RAID 5 server. How many of you have know that about RAID 5? RAID 5 is a equivalent tool of Adobe Flash streaming server, but it is open source. So there are four modules in AVU: login module, the front end and back end design with PHP, MySQL, and HTTP protocol. Now second module is video module. This is working on RTMP protocol using Flash Media Streaming Server. So you have to use this tool with RAID 5. And the login module you have to configure with PHP and MySQL database. And document module, this is also using PHP MySQL as a authentication of teachers, because only teacher can upload the document. And whiteboard, there is a function in Adobe software that you can share the object online. And front end design has been developed in Adobe Flex using Adobe Flex SDK. So you have to make all the front-end design in Adobe Flex. Login module is all the data have been registered in the database, MySQL database. So when user login, then check the authentication and login successful comes. After clicking that, after you will get another interface after the login. So suppose some of the users have been registered for a class A, and some of the students have been registered in a class B. So you have to define the class category virtualization. So whenever you you log in, then you will get a virtual classroom list in second interface. So when you double click on that virtual classroom, you will get all interface of the software. So video module, in video module you have to write a code for detecting the camera, detecting the mic, send stream to the streaming server, and access that stream to from streaming server. So to send streaming from client side or teacher side to streaming server, you have to encode that stream before sending the stream to the server. So you have to write an encoding program. It could be FLV encoder, H.264 encoder. Now document module. If registered user is a teacher, then he can upload document. So using PHP or MySQL, you can upload the document that would be visible to the interface of the AVU. Now whiteboard, when teacher write on whiteboard at the same time, that would be visible at the client side also. So all the features in RAID 5 is in the RAID 5, all the features is available in the RAID 5. So you have to configure all these according to the association. Document module, I forgot one thing. When teacher go to next page, at the same time that will be visible to client side also. This is the diagram for project. So you will need web server for connecting the connectivity. and it is connected to MySQL database for authentication. Suppose teacher connects web server and login, and like that all many students login in web server, check the authentication. After successful, then they can enter the classroom. So after that, the all the virtual classroom list will be visible, then he can select. Now come to the streaming part. It has a web server configured with streaming server. So for audio video, to send the audio video streaming, teacher encode that video part and send that stream to the streaming server. And at the same time, live streaming will go to all the connected clients. And whenever any user have a query, at that client side interface, you have to make a button as a trigger. Then they will press that button, that teacher may know that he has a query. So he will select that student and access the stream from streaming server. Access the video stream from streaming server. Like that, suppose teacher want to use a PPT slide. So he will upload a slide or any document in the upload directory that is associated with web server. So at the same time, the client also, client can access that slide. And whenever teacher go to next page, at the same time, it would be visible. And like that whiteboard also. When teacher write on the whiteboard, same time, it will be visible to the client side. So questions now. So last time, summer interns made a prototype bundle. First, you have to learn the Flex action script. Then we will provide that code to you. Just find out that there are some bugs. So you have to use that code, and I hope that you will get better opportunity, and will develop much more. Okay, thank you. Thank you.